I am Dr. W. P. Gunnare from Kamala Nehru Mahavidyalaya Nagpur. Today we are going to discuss the E and Z nomenclature of organic compounds. Already we have discussed what is geometrical isomerism, and geometrical isomerisms are two types, siege isomer and trans isomer. And in case of geometrical isomer, these are the isomers which are not enantiomers, and also there is a necessary condition, there should be a carbon-carbon double bond, so there is a rotation. Two substituents are present on each carbon, and these two substituents are same or different. Now when the substituents are different, four or three are there, in that case it is difficult to give the siege and trans isomer to the siege and trans isomer. Therefore, to solve this ambiguity, another system is given by Ingold, Prelog and also Kahn. And on the basis of the RES nomenclature, rules used in the RES nomenclature, same rules we have to follow here, and we have to find out the first priority and second priority. We have to see the priority in of the two atoms or group, and on the basis of that, when the two atoms, same atoms, as highest priority on the opposite side, then in that case the configuration is E. When they are on the same side, then it is known as the Z. So E and Z nomenclature we are discussing in today's presentation, and we are taking some examples how to find E and Z nomenclature of the organic compounds. So the topic is stereochemistry of organic compounds, and this is part number 13. And in this part number 13, we are discussing today mainly the EZ system of nomenclature. And already we have discussed what is geometrical isomerism, examples of geometrical isomerism, conditions of geometrical isomerism, and determination of configuration on from the different methods like melting point, boiling point, dipole moment, and also the solubility. And also we can determine the configuration of the organic compound on the basis of chemical reactions. And after that we are going to discuss the how to give the configuration E and Z to the organic compound. So this mainly we are discussing E and Z system of nomenclature of organic compound. So first of all, we have already known the determination of geometrical isomerism in case of the by using method from melting point, from dipole moment, from boiling point, and from solubility. Now this is the number 5 method from formation of cyclic compound, and in this case we can say that number 5, this on the basis of chemical reactions, that is from cyclic compound, formation of cyclic compound. In this case, as we know, these methods are more dependable as compared to physical methods. In siege isomer, the reacting groups being on the same side. So what is now, as we know, siege isomer and trans isomer. In siege isomer, the reacting group are present on the same side of the double bond. Therefore, they interact with each other, resulting in the formation of cyclic compound. So siege isomer gives cyclic compound. On the other side, we can say that in case of trans isomer, the reacting group are present on the opposite side of the double bond. Therefore, they do not interact with each other and do not form cyclic compound. So siege isomer form cyclic compound, trans isomer do not form cyclic compound. For example, malic acid is a siege isomer. Malic acid is a siege isomer. Here in the next slide it is shown example of malic acid. So in this case, this is the malic acid. At this temperature, just below the melting point of the malic acid, there is a loss of water. So OH and H from this, so OH and H, water get lost and we get anhydride. And this is possible. These are the reacting groups which are present on the one side of the of this compound, and therefore these are the reacting groups present on the one side. So malic acid is the, this is the isomer what is known as siege isomer. So in case of siege isomer, when there is a when we heat at this temperature, there is a loss of water, OH and H, and we get anhydride, so which is known as malic anhydride. Now in this case, so we can say siege isomer give cyclic compound. Now another transform of this malic acid is a fumaric acid. So this is the transposition. here is shown, and formula is same, but positions are, this is the trans isomer. This isomer also when heated will just below the melting point of fumaric acid, and so when this compound is heated at this temperature 573 Kelvin, again there is a loss of water molecule OH and H, and we get this anhydride. So when we heat this siege isomer, it gives the cyclic compound, but when this compound is heated at high temperature, they also give this anhydride. Now when this anhydride undergo the reaction, what is hydrolysis? When this compound undergo hydrolysis, so then again we get the malic acid, not we are getting the fumaric acid. So this is the reaction. So we know which is the siege isomer and which is the trans isomer. So siege and trans can be decided or can be determined from the formation of cyclic compound. So in this way, this is the reaction, and there is a loss of water. And lastly, we know that when fumaric acid is heated at 573 Kelvin, close to the melting point, it loses the water molecule and gives the same anhydride. And as we know, malic anhydride, since on the hydrolysis, it gives the malic acid and not the fumaric acid. So this is one method of a determination of siege and trans isomer. Next number, more sixth number method is there on the basis of optical properties of the stereoisomer formed during the hydroxylation and the bromination reaction. So hydroxylation and bromination. So in this case, optical properties of the product formed depends upon the stereochemistry of reactant. As we know, hydroxylation of alkene with dilute KMnO4. So two reactions are there. One is a hydroxylation, and second is the bromination. So this is the hydroxylation of alkene with the dilute KMnO4 solution, or osmium tetroxide is a siege addition process. So this hydroxylation is a siege addition process, and therefore siege isomer give meso product, while trans isomer give racemic mixture. So this is the important reaction on the basis of optical properties of the stereoisomers formed during the hydroxylation of this. So this is the hydroxylation shown in this slide, that optical properties of product formed depend upon the stereochemistry of the reactant. So hydroxylation of alkene with KMnO4 reaction is shown here, and in this case siege isomer give the meso compound, and trans give the mixture of, which is known as the racemic mixture, positive negative both. So in this case, so this is the malic acid, similar COH group are on the one side, and malic acid, this is the siege isomer. When it undergo the dilute hydroxylation with the KMnO4, or this in this case, then siege addition is taking place and we get the compound. So hydroxylation is here, two hydrogens already are there, and COH are on the two, the COH group are at the 2-8, and the hydroxylation OH are here. So this is the meso compound, and known as the meso tartaric acid. This is the, after hydroxylation, we get meso tartaric acid. So siege isomer give meso compound. And now what is trans isomer? Undergo the hydroxylation with KMnO4, we get this type of compound. So one OH is here, another OH is here. In this case, positions are changed. Here OH, and in this case OH and EH are here. So this is the positive tartaric acid, and this is negative tartaric acid. So in this case, we get the racemic mixture. So by the reaction hydroxylation of alkene, siege isomer give meso compound, trans isomer give racemic mixture. One more reaction is there. What is the bromination reaction? Now in case of bromination, in contrast, the bromination of alkene is a trans addition process. So this is the trans addition process, and hydroxylation is a siege addition process. Therefore, trans alkene give meso product, while siege alkene give racemic product. So here is shown, this is the trans to butane and undergo bromination. Trans to butane undergo bromination in presence of CCl4, and we get, in this case trans addition is taking place, and here are the meso compound. This is the 2 PR added here, H, CST, CST. So meso 2,3 dibromobutane, and siege isomer. This is the siege isomer, trans addition taking place, bromination is here. So we get plus minus, that is racemic mixture is obtained. So contrast to that, bromination of the alkene give this contrast reaction of, as compared to hydroxylation. So in case of hydroxylation and in case of bromination, trans isomer give the meso compound and cis give the mixture, racemic mixture. So these are the reactions on the basis of chemical reaction. Also, it is possible to determine the cis and trans isomer when the four substituent groups are present on the carbons. Now, important method of nomenclature is the E and Z system of nomenclature. Now, cis and trans, in case of this, we know that cis and trans notation can be used without any ambiguity to describe the spatial arrangement or spatial orientation of the two identical atoms or group around the double bond. As we know, cis and trans notation can be used without any ambiguity to describe the spatial orientation of the two identical atoms or group around the double bond. However, in case of tri and tetra substituted alkene, in which three or four different atoms or group are attached to the carbon atoms of the double bond, it is difficult to assign cis and trans notation to a pair of geometrical isomers. And therefore, so as we know, it is difficult to assign cis and trans notation to the geometrical isomer. Therefore, consider the formation of, or to illustrate this, we can consider the formation of geometrical isomers of 1-bromo-2-chloro-2-fluoro-1-iodoethene. So it is shown around the double bond. This is the example. Carbon-carbon double bond is there. All the four atoms are different. So what is the cis and what is trans in this case? Then it is not possible which is cis and trans on the basis of geometrical isomer. Already we have seen in case of geometrical two isomers are there, cis and trans. Now in this case, which is cis and trans? So there is another method, that is EZ. We can now here. When the two similar atoms are present on the one side, it is cis. Present on the opposite side, then it is the trans. But now here, four atoms are different. Present on the carbon, each carbon, and therefore, which one is a cis and trans? So in this case, therefore we can say that bromine and chlorine are trans to each other. We also say equally accurately that iodine and Cl are cis to each other. Therefore, it is difficult to name such substances either as a cis isomer or trans isomer. Therefore, to avoid this ambiguity, more general system of nomenclature known as is developed, and this is known as the E and Z system of nomenclature. This system is based upon the priority sequence rule. Again, now E and Z system of nomenclature based on the priority sequence rules, originally developed by Kahn, Ingold and Prelog to describe the configuration about the chiral center in the molecule. So the two important points are there in case of in this case there are two important points. Two points are there in case of EZ system, and important points are, number one, following the sequence rule which we have already used in our RS system, following the sequence rule we can describe the optically active compound. And in this case, priority order is assigned to the two atoms or group attached to each carbon at the double bond. Again, now I'm repeating. First point is that we have to use the sequence rule of the optically active compounds, and we have to find priority order is to be assigned to the two atoms or group attached to each carbon. मतलब एक कार्बन पे दो एटम्स होंगे या ग्रुप्स होंगे, उनको प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर देना है. और फिर उसके बाद में सेकंड रूल यूज करना है. सेकंड रूल इज दैट इफ द एटम और ग्रुप ऑफ हायर प्रायोरिटी आर प्रेजेंट ऑन ईच कार्बन एटम ऑफ द डबल बॉन्ड आर प्रेजेंट ऑन द अपोजिट साइड ऑफ द डबल बॉन्ड, हाइएस्ट प्रायोरिटी एटम्स दो ग्रुप्स है, दो एटम्स है, उनका हाइएस्ट प्रायोरिटी अपोजिट साइड में अगर है डबल बॉन्ड के, then the configuration is denoted as E. On the other side, if the two atoms or group of the higher priority on each carbon atom of the double bond are on the same side of the double bond, then the configuration is denoted as J. So there are two, E and J. When they are position opposites, it is clear from this example now. So now here, this is the carbon-carbon double bond. This is 1, 2. Here, each carbon have two atoms, 1, 2. And this is, one is having high and this is low. In another carbon having two atoms, and this is having low and this is having high. So one is high and second is low. Now see, high, high. The highest priority here on this carbon is here, here. They are present opposite. So this is the configuration, is the E isomer. And here, highest priority are present on the one side, high, high. So this is, it is known as the Z isomer. So when it is E, when it is Z, is clear from this priority order. High are present opposite, then E. When high, high, priority present on one side is known as the Z isomer. Again, it is clear. We are taking some examples. Illustration of the rule. दो रूल्स है, उसको अगर आपने को अच्छे से समझाना है तो ये देखो, यहाँ पे एग्जाम्पल दिया है. दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल, 1, 2, 3, 4. ये चारों भी एटम अलग है. देयर इज अ कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड. नेम ऑफ द कंपाउंड इज 1 ब्रोमो 2 क्लोरो 2 फ्लोरो 1 आयोडो इथीन. ये इसका नाम है, ये है कंपाउंड 1 ब्रोमो 2 क्लोरो 2 फ्लोरो 1 आयोडो इथीन. तो इसमें देखो, अभी ये जैसा कार्बन है, आयोडीन और ब्रोमीन, तो हाईएस्ट प्रायोरिटी किसका एटम नंबर ज्यादा है, ये 1, और बी आर उसके बाद में एटम नंबर कम है तो ये 2. इसको नंबर देना 1, इसको नंबर 2. दूसरा कार्बन जो है उसमें सी एल और एफ, तो जिसका एटम नंबर ज्यादा है वो 1 और जिसका कम है वो 2. तो अभी देखो, 1 1 और 2 2, हाईएस्ट प्रायोरिटी वाले कौन से हैं, 2. दिस इज 2 एंड दिस इज 2, अपोजिट. सो इट इज ई. इन दिस केस नाउ दिस इज द कंपाउंड. नाउ सी हियर द पोजिशन इज चेंज. So this is the name of the compound. And here, यहाँ पे देखो 2 2, ये देखो 2 2, तो highest priority on one same side. So this is the Z. So this is E isomer, this is Z isomer. We can know the E and Z configuration. Another example देखो, दूसरा और example है, C or trans isomer of 2-butene can be denoted as Z and E 2-butene. तो E और Z कैसा है, देखो 2-butene का example है. इस 2-ब्यूटीन में ये देखो, अभी इसमें ये जो कार्बन है इसमें 2 है, एक एटम है हाइड्रोजन और ये सीएससी. तो सीएससी इज द 1 अकॉर्डिंग टू प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर, अपन ने देखा है. ये हाइड्रोजन इज 2 सेकंड, ये इसके हो गए. इस दूसरा कार्बन है उसमें 2 है एटम और ग्रुप, तो इसका नंबर, ये नंबर 1 और इसका नंबर 2. अभी देखो 1 1, सेम प्रायोरिटी, हाइएस्ट प्रायोरिटी 1 1 एक साइड में है, तो ये इसका कॉन्फिगरेशन है, आइसोमर कौन सा है, जेड. और इसमें देखो, अभी इसको चेंज किया है, ए 2-ब्यूटीन है, ए 2-ब्यूटीन है, तो इसमें देखो अभी पोजीशन चेंज किया है, सी एस सी एच, यहाँ पे एच और यहाँ पे सी एस सी, कंपाउंड का नाम वही है 2-ब्यूटीन. पोजीशन इज चेंज ऑफ द एटम्स. अभी इसमें देखो सी एस सी 1, सी एस सी 1, ये कैसा है, अपोजिट. इसका नाम है, इसका कॉन्फिगरेशन है ई. तो जेड और ई, इस टाइप से ये सेकेंड एग्जाम्पल. नाउ इट इज क्लियर टू यू. एंड थर्ड एग्जाम्पल भी इसमें दिया है, मैरिक एसिड एंड फ्यूमैरिक एसिड मे बी डिनोटेड एज ई एंड जेड आइसोमर. इसमें जैसा दिखाया है, देखो अभी इसमें निकालोगे ये 1 और ये 2, ये 1 और ये 2, तो 1 1 ऑन द सेम साइड, सो इट इज अ जेड. अनदर एग्जांपल, नाउ 1 1 आर पेजेंट अपोजिट, सो इट इज अ फ्यूमैरिक एसिड, इज अ ई आइसोमर. सो व्हेन इट इज जेड, व्हेन इट इज ई, नाउ इट इज क्लियर फ्रॉम द प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर. सिर्फ दो एटम या ग्रुप का प्रायोरिटी निकालना है. When two priority of the two atoms are on the same side, it is Z. When they are on the opposite, so it is known as the E isomer. So today we have seen what is the simple method is there of E and Z nomenclature of organic compounds. So in case of E Z system of nomenclature, we can know which compound is the E isomer and Z isomer. And in this case, the isomerism, when the we have to find out the two priority order present on the each carbon, two substituent are there on the each carbon of the double bond, and we have to give the priority order high and low. And when the high priority on both the carbons are on same side, then it is Z. And when they are on the opposite to each other, then it is a E. So E and Z isomers are there, and this method we have to use to know the cis and trans isomer when the four different or three different substituent atoms are grouped position on the double bonded carbon of the organic compounds. So today we stop here. In the next part we will discuss the conformation isomerism.